Hello and welcome to Skyvia Tutorials. In today's video, we will check how to integrate HubSpot with SQL Server. Skyvia allows you to create a copy of your HubSpot data in a database or data warehouse, keep it up to date, and set up a full integration in any direction between HubSpot and a database or data warehouse of your choice. It supports connecting HubSpot to SQL Server, Postgres, MySQL, Azure, Snowflake, BigQuery, Redshift, and others. For this tutorial, we chose the following scenarios. Replication of the HubSpot data to SQL Server and the reverse ETL of the data from SQL Server to HubSpot. This tutorial assumes you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have it, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Before you start building integrations between HubSpot and SQL Server, make sure to create a connection to each of them. To create a connection to HubSpot, click Create New and select Connection. Choose HubSpot and log in with your credentials. There are two ways of creating a connection to SQL Server, direct, and through the agent. Use direct connection if your SQL Server is accessible through the internet. To create a direct connection, click New, select Connection, and look for SQL Server. Enter the server's address, your user ID, password, and select the database to connect to. If your SQL Server is located on your local computer or network, use agent connection. In this case, Skyvia will connect to the database server via agent application that acts as a secure layer between Skyvia and your database server. To create a connection through agent, you need to download the agent app first by clicking New and choosing Agent. From here, download it and install it on your computer. Also on this page, you can see your agent's key. Copy it to paste in the agent's UI once you run the agent app, or download it and place it in the same folder with the agent app, so the key will be inserted automatically. It's also recommended to name your agent so you will be able to locate it easily in the future. Once you've downloaded and installed the agent app, let's create a new connection. Click New, select Connection, and look for SQL Server. Select the agent connection mode at the top. Choose your agent from the drop-down list and enter the server's IP address, your user ID, password, and database to connect to. While using the connection through agent, make sure that the agent app is launched. If nothing happens when you launch it, right-click on it and choose Run as Administrator. Now, when connections to HubSpot and SQL Server are created, we can move to our scenarios. Let's start with the replication of HubSpot data to SQL Server. To replicate your data, click New and choose Replication. Select HubSpot as source and SQL Server as target. Choose the objects you want to replicate from the list on the right. All the fields of selected objects will be replicated by default. If you want to replicate specific fields only, click Edit. Here you can manually mark fields for replication and apply custom filters. If you have new replication runtime enabled, you can select replication modes per object and hash-sensitive data if needed. Replication modes that are available are Standard, which is assigned to each object automatically and applies the default replication behavior. Resync, which forces the full replication of the object by dropping and creating a table in target during each replication run. Resync on demand, which is created for objects that are part of your replication but are not required for each replication run. With resync on demand, you can include the object in the next replication run by resetting its last sync time. There is also a history mode. Use it to track the history of the entries in your database. Enable it for the chosen objects in source to store every change made to the object's rows in target, using the type 2 slowly changing dimension. It basically adds a few more fields to your object that help to keep multiple versions of the same rows and check the status of the row and its changes during the specific period of time. Skyvia supports hashing field values to conceal sensitive information when loading data to databases and data warehouses. To hash a field, hover over it, click Unhashed, and select Hashed. Once done with configurations, click Save. Additionally, you can customize integration-wide replication options. Enable incremental updates to include only changes applied to data since the last replication run. Select the Update Schema checkbox to apply data structure changes made in the cloud app to the database schema in target. Also, you can choose to create or drop tables. Note that when the incremental updates are enabled, tables will be created only during the first replication run. Once this is done, you can run or schedule your replication as you see fit. Let's schedule the replication to run every day at 7 a.m. Paris time. After you run the replication, you can check the execution status and its results on the monitor and log tabs. Here you will see the number of successfully replicated rows and error messages in case something went wrong. In addition to replicating HubSpot data to SQL Server, you can perform a reverse ETL, return important data from SQL Server back to HubSpot with the help of Skyvia import, so the business teams can use it to perform operational tasks. Skyvia import is a wizard-based ETL tool. To start using it, click Create New and choose Import. Select SQL Server as source and HubSpot as target. To define what data to load from SQL Server to HubSpot, where to load it, and how to map it, create an import task by clicking Add New. You can add any number of import tasks to your integration. Let's import company score data by selecting company score from the drop-down list. Here you can optionally apply filters to data. For example, let's choose company with score lower than 1 and click Next Step. On the target definition page, select the company's object in HubSpot to load data into and one of the available operations, insert, update, upsert, or delete. Insert adds source data to target. Update updates the values in target according to values in source. Upsert combines insert and update operations and adds new records while updating existing ones. Delete deletes the records from target. As we are interested in inserting new records while updating the existing ones, we continue with the upsert operation. Skyvia tries to map fields automatically. However, you can remap any field as you see fit. There are four mapping types available: column, constant, lookup, and expression. Once fields are mapped, click Save Task. Now you can save and run your import, schedule it for future runs, check the current import execution and the results of your previous imports. Let's create a schedule for it, then run it and check the log details. To check the results of the current and past integrations, use Monitor and Log tabs. If some rows fail to import, you will receive a detailed error log. Also, you can set up email notifications to receive in case of partial or complete fail of your integration. For those who like building ETL pipelines, Skyvia created Dataflow, a visual ETL data pipeline designer. With the help of Dataflow, you can create complex logic that includes multiple data sources and conditions. Here you can perform the same import or apply additional data transformation with the help of Dataflow components. For example, here we add a custom field based on two other fields available in SQL Server. Thank you for watching this SQL Server and HubSpot integration tutorial. If you have any additional questions, feel free to drop us a comment below and we will help you. To try Skyvia for free, use the link in the description. See you in the next videos.